In this video, I'll be explaining why NIO is hiring somebody from Nvidia, so a chip maker related to gaming. But before I'm talking more about NIO's autonomous driving ambitions, some housekeeping here. Somebody just sent me this. So this is Fintel information about short sell volume in NIO stock, and that one is off exchanges. So that's in dark pools, that's not in the open market. And as you can see, it's been rising from 38% up to now close to 50% of the volume of traded stocks in these dark pools are being shorted right now. So while the short interest in NIO is relatively low in the open market, just 4% of the float is being shorted, it seems like the combined effect of both the exchanges and the off exchanges are almost to 50% right now. So this is a considerable volume building up, betting against NIO stock here. Now, people sometimes ask me in the comments what can be done about this, and frankly, I cannot even say like how much of this activity would be kind of illegal in dark pools, in naked short selling and stuff like that. All that I can say is more on the fundamental side that I see stories spreading about NIO out there that are definitely false. One, I made a video about that one, was about the departure of Ren Xiaoqing, so one of the most important figures in autonomous driving, and I made the video about this. I can link it again here. And then I also urge you to watch another video by Mr. P, and shout out here to his channel. I think he's doing fantastic work. Recently, also another video about should you sell NIO stock or not. I really enjoyed those kind of videos. And he made another video about a new video about a NIO pilot crashing. And personally, when I watched the video, I thought it is kind of staged or something seems to be not okay with this. And he has really done a great job at explaining it. So I recommend watching it, and thereby you also get a better understanding about what I'm talking now next about autonomous driving. But first of all, to continue the story about short selling, it enables us to buy NIO factually cheaper as well. So basically, it's also a gift if you're a long-term investor, because at some point in time, if the company is following up with their potential and on the fundamental side is working out well, then obviously you will have the benefit. You were able to buy the shares cheaper because of the short selling. So if you come to the conclusion and you are in the opinion that NIO is trading relatively cheap compared to other growth stocks or other EV companies, then the best idea for you would be to accumulate shares or maybe buying the cheap call options. But another way that would maybe drive out short sellers would be possibly if we are setting a sell order for the stock that we are owning at a very high price, so they are not getting filled. But this could lead on a broader scale that the shares cannot be borrowed. So usually some of the brokers cannot borrow those shares out to the short seller, and thereby tightening the supply there. And this could have some effect theoretically. But anyways, that's just a quick reaction to some of the comments I'm getting. I'm in there for the long run anyways, so I think this problem will get solved over time anyways. So back to topic. The question of this video is, why has NIO hired Steve Hsieh, who is now the head of simulation at NIO? And heads up here to CNEV Post, who has actually found this out and published it in an article. And it's an interesting persona because he previously was the principal product manager and senior manager for autonomous vehicles at Nvidia. And also he was working at GM's Cruise, which is of course about level 4 autonomy. Now NIO is not talking too much about their autonomy program, but I mentioned yesterday that the CFO mentioned that NIO is very confident that in the end investors will find that NIO's NAD must be the most advanced among all Chinese automakers, and that they have built up most of the in-house capabilities and have recruited lots of talent for it last year. Just as a reminder, one of the most important people working with NIO is Ren Xiaoqing, who has written this paper about deep residual learning for image recognition. And he's one of the most cited authors in the field of computer vision, deep learning, and autonomous driving. Now, what could this person bring additionally to the team? And I have my suspicions there. Well, first of all, it's clear that there seems to be a very strong cooperation between Nvidia and NIO. So NIO is the first company to adopt this newest Orin chipset by Nvidia. And so it's no surprise really that we see quite a bit of overlap between executives and also insiders there between NIO and Nvidia. But why would NIO team up or hire people from like a kind of a gaming related company that Nvidia is? And I think the answer to that might be data, and that might be something similar to what Tesla is doing with the Dojo, so the supercomputer that Tesla is developing or building up in order to train the neural networks. And as I've just shown with Ren Xiaoqing, I think NIO is much likely to go down a similar way by training their neural networks, improving the image recognition patterns for all of the sensoring suites, so the cameras and the LiDAR that NIO's ET7 and ET5 will have, and combining this data based on the algorithms developed by Ren Xiaoqing and the team to make level 4 autonomous driving possible in after a couple of iterations. Now, what you need for that is, of course, data. And NIO, of course, has their own fleet. So the fleet has been collecting data since the beginnings. The ES8, the ES6, they have all been already with quite an advanced chipset for their time and been collecting this data. And of course, the next cars will only continue to do so. Additionally, NIO can actually tap also into the data of this Intel Mobileye partnership, because NIO is the preferred partner for that in China, but not only in China, also in Israel and in Munich. And I think, Intel Mobileye is possibly collecting data all over the world with their so-called REM set that they are developing. And so I think, NIO is getting data from various sources there, possibly even linked a little bit to what Baidu is doing on top of that. But coming back to this persona here, the core thing about this is, like, what can you do with this data? And I think there is some learnings that we can have from the AI and gaming field here.
Whenever we change something in the game, our changes may also have unintended consequences somewhere else away from where we applied them. New oversights may appear elsewhere. For instance, moving a platform may make the level more playable. However, also, this might happen. The player may now be able to enter a part of the level that shouldn't be accessible, or be more likely to encounter a collision bug and get stuck. Unfortunately, all this means that it's not enough to just test what we have changed, but we have to retest the whole level, or maybe the whole game itself, for every single change, no matter how small. That not only takes a ton of time and effort, but is often flat out impractical. So, what is the solution? Apparently, a proper solution would require asking tons of curious humans to test the game. But, wait a second, we already have curious, learning-based algorithms. Can we use them for playtesting? That sounds amazing. Well, yes, until we try it. You see, here is an automated agent, but a naive one, trying to explore the level. Unfortunately, it seems to have missed half the map. Well, that's not the rigorous testing we are looking for, is it? Let's see what this new AI offers. Can it do any better? Oh my, now we're talking. The new technique was able to explore not less than 50%, but a whopping 95% of the map. Excellent. But we are experienced fellow scholars over here, so of course we have some questions. Apparently, this one has great coverage, so it can cruise around, great. But our question is, can these AI agents really find game-breaking issues? Well, look, it just found a bug where it could climb to the top of the platform without having to use the elevator. It can also build a graph that describes which parts of the level are accessible and through what path. Look, this visualization tells us about the earlier issue where one could climb the wall through an unintentional issue, and after the level designer supposedly fixed it by adjusting the steepness of the wall. Let's see the new path. Yes, now it could only get up there by using the elevator. That is the intended way to traverse the level. Excellent. And it gets better. It can even tell us the trajectories that enabled it to leave the map, so we know exactly what issues we need to fix without having to look through hours and hours of video footage. And whenever we apply the fixes, we can easily unleash another bunch of these AIs to search every nook and cranny and try these crazy strategies, even ones that don't make any sense but appear to work well.
So what you have seen there in the area of game development is that it's industry standards that they're using learning algorithms in order to test a virtual world, a 3D world with a subset of data, and then using this initial subset to extrapolate and let the computers or the neural networks learn around how the world is actually looking like, finding bugs and finding basically the game patterns in that example, but translating that into the area of autonomous driving. What could possibly be done is that somebody like this guy who's working on simulation now at NIO will be using the data that NIO has gathered and create these kind of real-world examples of mapping data and using the algorithms in order to extrapolate the data as well, and thereby training the neural networks and the autonomous driving algorithms. And this also gets clear if we look at the patterns that Steve has been working on, like map updates based on data captured by autonomous vehicles, a task management system for high-definition maps, human-like autonomous vehicle behavior based on map prior layer, and the list goes on. So as I said, initially, NIO doesn't talk much about this, and we won't see NIOs driving around and testing this or any FSD-like videos that we are seeing from Tesla currently. However, this kind of hirings and what I see here in the background is at least through my lens how I'm reading this, that NIO is working in a similar fashion here and having some kind of a key hirings there that should be very interesting. I don't know what will be like the roadmap for this and the rollout. Of course, this will be an iterative system and NIO will be gradually rolling out those features in the future, I would say so. Maybe we'll hear about that in the next NIO day, I don't know. Anyways, I just wanted to throw out how I'm thinking about this hiring and what I think is possibly going on in the background. We'll definitely cover this more because I have some additional insights to that and thoughts around how NIO is going to approach this problem of autonomous driving. Anyways, I hope you find this useful. Thank you guys for watching and see you in the next one.